Whatever happened to free speech? More and more people are saying, asking, lamenting, as they see all these stories of individuals being mobbed, silenced, deplatformed for their opinions. It's a good question, and I think I have something resembling an answer, something that I've seen increasing more and more over recent years, coming to a fever pitch really just this year, which is that people seem to feel entitled now to get indignant, shocked, and surprised to learn that not everybody thinks exactly like them. It is very bizarre. I don't know where this has come from. In the United States, in Canada, you have, well, in the US, you have two main political parties. In Canada, you have three or four. And it just stands to reason that there's going to be results in those elections where the vote is split. Not everybody is uniform in it. So it should not surprise you that some people you know, maybe even your neighbors, maybe even your family members, vote a different way than you do. Maybe they have a slightly different opinion on some of the big issues of the day. And that's just how a free society works. And you may hold your views very strongly, very proudly, whatever views they are on the spectrum, on whatever issue. Okay, that's fine. But you've got to just understand as a human being out and about in society that other people are also going to hold their views passionately and informed views, still different ones than you, but they've just come to different conclusions. I know most of you are just nodding saying, why are you even bothering covering this territory? Yes, we know human beings are diverse. They think in very diverse ways, but we've increasingly seen people, I think, just be shocked to learn that folks don't think like them, don't vote like them. And that is what has increased and worsened. And I think what has caused so much of this tension we're seeing right now. For years now, I've been appearing on TV panels, radio panels, where there are people who think a complete 180 from me, and I'm never flabbergasted by it. And I think here's the other point. I never go, that person disagrees with me. Well, I have to go and get them, and I have to find a way to make them lose the things that are important to them, their jobs or their platform or what have you, and punish them for this. Who thinks like that? But more and more people are getting indignant to learn people don't think like them, and then they want to pile on them and have them lose things and make them suffer for it. And that is so sad. That's where we're at right now, and we really need to take a step away from that and just realize, yeah, human beings have all different perspectives, and that's what happens in a free society. Because if you don't anymore, and if you're not able to have those different perspectives, well then, are you still a free society?